beard, or sorry, beard trees, and paper ID number 83. Are you going to share your screen? Okay, cool.
Hi, can you see me and hear?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Beatrice, an undergraduate student at UFCG, and I'm going to talk about identifying mutation subsumption relations. So, mutation testing is a powerful technique to assess the quality of test suites. The idea behind mutation testing is that we change code snippets of our programs, also called mutation targets, and create slightly different faulty versions of our programs called mutants. Then we run our tests against each mutant, and if at least a test case fails, that means that our test has killed the mutant, otherwise the mutant survived. The effectiveness of our tests is given by the percentage of killed mutants. Notice that only for the equals target, we can create 15 mutations. In our programs, we usually have many mutation targets, so the amount of mutants that can be created is really large. Mutation testing tools create mutants based on synthetic changes. However, are all of those mutants really useful? Some mutants are synthetically different, but they are semantically equivalent to the original program. Some mutants are semantically equivalent to other mutants. And some mutants are subsumed. A mutation 1 subsums a mutation 2 when the set of test cases that kills mutation 1 is a strict subset of the test cases that kills mutation 2. So whenever we kill mutation 1, we also kill mutation 2. Redundant mutants require necessary effort to create, compile, execute tests against them. Moreover, redundant mutants inflate a mutation score. We propose a technique to find redundant mutations based on theorem proving with Z3. For each mutation target, we declare the possible mutations for that target. Then we remove equivalent mutants by proving whether each mutation is semantically equivalent to the target. We remove duplicate mutations by proving whether each mutation is semantically equivalent to other mutations. Then we find subsumption relations by proving whether each mutation subsumes the other ones. What we have in the end is a minimal set of mutations that should apply for the received target. Notice that for the equals target, we had 15 mutations, but our technique said that only 3 are useful, so it's a reduction of 80%. Here is a part of the encoding of our technique in the Z3 Python API to prove theorems and identify subsumption relations. We applied our technique for 40 mutation targets. Our technique produces the results only in a few seconds, and the reduction of mutations is around 59%. Our technique is sound. We prove properties among mutations. However, mutation testing is usually used with entire programs. So we evaluate our technique with entire programs. MeJava is a mutation testing tool which creates mutants for programs written in Java. We modified MeJava to only apply the useful mutations based on our findings. We applied MeJava and our tool to 17 real projects, and MeJava generated more than 7,000 mutants, while our technique only generated almost 2,000 mutants. So it's a reduction greater than 72%. We also evaluated the effectiveness of our technique, and our technique correctly discards mutations in more than 75% of the cases and is better than random sampling. So our technique presents a good balance between the effectiveness and the effort required to find redundant mutations. Moreover, we compared equivalent mutants detected by TCA, which is a technique to identify equivalent mutants based on bytecode instrumentations, with equivalent mutants detected by our technique. And our technique detects all the equivalent mutants detected by TCA with less effort. So besides seeming valuable to identify redundant mutations, our technique also seems valuable to identify infeasible mutations. Thanks. I'm happy to take any questions that you may have.
Thanks for the presentation. So I realized that you use MuJava to generate mutants. So yeah, could you explain why you choose that tool? Because there are other popular ones like PyTest and Major. So why you don't use those two tools? Thanks.
Exactly. MeJava create mutants for mutation targets, for example, like these ones. And we can see Mijava generates source code of the mutant, while our other techniques like PyTest create mutants on the bytecode. So we couldn't analyze the bytecode of the mutants if we had created that with other tool, for example.
Thanks.
Okay, thanks for the presentation. Do we have any other questions? Okay, it seems we don't have more questions. Please contact Beatrice if you have more questions. And thanks a lot for your presentations. Everyone, thanks to our judges for your time judging this session, asking really valuable questions.